Lesson 4.2.1, Creating and Interpreting Frequency Distribution. In this video, we will construct bar graphs to represent data given in frequency marginal distribution tables. What do you call a tiger that likes to dig in the sand? The sandy claws. So we're going to go ahead and make a bar graph by class. So the first thing I want you to do is click on 13B, and then I want you to click on the box that says Insert Chart. It's a square shaped box with three lines on it. So this is what it selected for me. We're going to go ahead and change standard to none. And down here, we're going to unselect the switch. We're going to unselect column A. And then we'll unselect the user, use row 13 as a header, and then reselect it. Up here, where it says data range, we want to make sure it says B13 to F15. So now our bar graphs look pretty good, but we need to clean up some labeling of the information. So under Customize, we're going to click on Chart and Axis Titles. And we want it on Chart Style. We want it on Chart Title. And our chart title is going to be bar graph by class. The other label we want to do is the horizontal axis title and the vertical axis title. So click on the horizontal axis title. We're going to remove what's there, if there's anything there. We're going to label it class, because that's what our horizontal axis is, class A and class B. Then we're going to click on vertical axis title, or I should say we're going to click on the horizontal axis title and change it to the vertical axis title. And there we're talking about the number of student responses. And you'll notice that label comes along the side. Okay, the horizontal label went down at the bottom, class AB, number of student responses, and our legend has the colors. Now if you look at the colors, we have blue labeled as blue, we have red labeled as green, yellow is labeled as purple, and green is labeled as red, which is all confusing. So let's go ahead and click on the red box in the chart. And off to the right, you should have had something that pops up that says formatting and it says auto color. Our auto color, we can change it to green. So now green matches green, the word. If we click on the yellow box and go auto, and we can click on purple, and now purple is labeled purple. That makes more sense. And the last one is the green one, which should be red. And we're going to go ahead and click on auto and change it to red. So now the colors in our graph match the color titles of each. We can slide this down here by clicking on it and dragging it. And then if you click the bottom right hand corner of it and hold the click and drag it, it'll shrink it and so that it fits in the box. So that's how we make a bar graph by class. What I'd like you to do is try number two. Same idea. We're going to make a bar graph by class. Don't forget to click on B13 and then the square with the three lines in it. So go ahead and do that now. Now that you've tried it, I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing. change standard to none. And I'm going to come down here, change that A to a B. And then I'm going to come down to the bottom here. We don't want to switch the rows and columns. I don't want this bottom one. And I'm going to click on the middle one and then click on it a second time. The first time, for whatever reason, unreleases everything. And then the second time puts the titles back in. We are definitely missing a title. We're missing basketball. So down here under Add Series, if you click Add Series, basketball shows up, and all you have to do is select basketball, and now it shows up in your graph. Again, like last time, we're going to customize, and we're going to change the chart information. It's already on vertical axis title, so we'll just go ahead and put number of students or student responses. We'll go to vertical chart or axis title and call that a class. You'll notice the title matches the word that's next to it, right? This is the horizontal, this was the vertical, or actually I should say the vertical is just number of student responses. And then the last part is the chart title. Chart title is not 11th and 12th graders, it is bar graph by class. And voila, we have what we want. Like last time, if you don't like the colors that are there, you're welcome to click on the color. Change the auto color to whatever you want. Let's just say I want it to be green. Or maybe I want it to be white. No, white doesn't look good. Let's go with orange. Okay, so those are my three colors. So you can change the colors just by clicking on them. Last thing we'll do is we're going to shift this over. Slide it in. You'll notice that the stuff on the graph matches the stuff in your table. So the 11th grade football is 3. 11th grade baseball is 3. And 11th grade basketball is 4. And then we got 6, 2, and 2. 6, 2, and 2. Okay, in the same order that you see it in the table. So with that, that's how you make a bar graph by class. In the next video, we'll make a bar graph by sport or color or whatever the second thing is.